6.
A Cape Coral woman with a disturbing obsession makes hundreds of threatening phone calls to NASCAR legend Tony Stewart and his family. Good evening, I'm Kelly Burns.
And I'm Peter Bush. Investigators say 68-year-old Kathy Russell called the family more than 300 times, leaving terrifying messages. NBC2's Trent Kelly is outside the Lee County Justice Complex, where Russell appeared before a judge.
Well, according to a 19-page affidavit filed in court last week, this all began after Tony Stewart ignored Russell's requests for an autograph at a racing event last year. That sparked a series of events that now has the 68-year-old woman on her way to Indiana tonight, where she's facing some very serious charges.
Had no idea we had a lunatic nearby.
Cape Coral residents in disbelief after learning their neighbor is accused of threatening and stalking a NASCAR legend.
But I didn't know she was so paranoid. She's got a screw loose.
Officers arrested Kathy Russell on Monday after court documents show the 68-year-old repeatedly called NASCAR driver Tony Stewart and his family more than 330 times over the last year and a half. Leaving behind clips from this Talking Heads song, as well as this soundbite from Hillary Clinton.
We came, we saw, he died.
Maybe she stopped taking her medication or something.
Brenda Kurz and her daughter Amber live just a few homes away.
She would always call the cops on us and be like, people are watching us. And I'm like, no, we just don't have enough room in the driveway.
We stopped by Russell's home today.
Any comment on Ms. Russell's arrest?
But her family declined to talk. Tonight, Russell's neighbors just hope she gets the help she needs.
She definitely needs help if that's what she did. And hopefully she won't be back here.
Now, on top of all those phone calls, Russell is also accused of sending a white powder to an Indianapolis law firm. The same law firm, by the way, Tony Stewart's mother hired to help get a protective order against Russell. On top of that, Russell's also accused of filing a false report with the DEA, claiming Stewart had drugs on his plane. Tonight, she faces a slew of charges, including stalking, intimidation, and causing terroristic mischief. We are live in Lee County.